So because we've simplified device architecture and because we're increasing the performance massively over incumbent technologies, the foundation technology behind this is very rugged and very useful in difficult environments that you wouldn't normally see photonics into going into.
Hello, you're watching Proactive. Joining me is Ben Jensen, CEO of 2D Photonics, a new frontier IP group portfolio company. Ben, very good to speak with you. You've just raised 25 million euros to accelerate developments and scale up your advanced graphene photonics. And you've also attracted an impressive array of investors from industry, government, and finance. What's attracting them to your technology?
Thank you very much for having me, Stephen. I think a couple of interesting points here. One, the investor pool that we have is really showing to the quality of the technology that we're developing and the need in the market for that technology. So, what's required today is ever faster data transmission at lower costs. So, we see it every day in the news around AI, 5G communications, basically, everywhere data is being used. There's a requirement to go faster, but also a requirement from the data providers to reduce the cost. Our technology is very, very relevant in this area because we've developed a new device architecture in photonics using graphene. And with that new device architecture, we've simplified the design. So we improve the power performance of transmitting that data whilst increasing the bandwidth. And that's absolutely critical for the future of data communications.
Ben, what will the proceeds from the funding round be invested in?
Great question. So we're a startup company, so we need to build the management team out. So execution of this type of technology is absolutely critical. So in the near future, we'll be bringing on senior team members at C-level and also vice president levels for engineering and photonics design, and also to scale up the technology. So we're just at the starting phase of the process where we have really innovative technology. But the end game is to get it into high volume production. And there's a journey to be taken between the two. So the first part is build out the senior team, then build out pilot production capability, demonstrating to the world that this is a viable technology and that it can be scaled into a semiconductor foundry, which is the end objective, high volume manufacturing of the technology.
So, Ben, what's next for the company and the technology?
Well, very, very interesting. So because we've simplified device architecture and because we're increasing the performance massively over incumbent technologies, the foundation technology behind this is very rugged and very useful in difficult environments that you wouldn't normally see photonics into going into. So that means we can now address critical applications in space and defense that haven't been addressed before, but have a need to move data in the same way. So, and also other applications that are very, very relevant. This is what we call automated driver assistance systems. So with electrification of vehicles and ADAS systems helping drivers stay on the road and prevent crashes, the technology is very relevant there, where you're moving lots of data around rapidly from camera systems into computer systems and other sensors to keep cars and drivers safe on the road.
Ben, I hope you'll keep us updated on any progress. Thank you very much for the introduction today.
Fantastic. Thank you for having me.